بذكر الله ترتاح القلوب وتنزاح المتاعب والكروب.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي المبارك وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علمًا يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنةً وفي الآخرة حسنةً وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم نوِّر قلوبنا بأنوار معرفتك ومحبتك وخشيتك وذكرك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا الصدق والإخلاص واليقين وأخلاق الصالحين. اللهم ارزقنا الشوق إليك والأنس بك، واجعل قرة العين في الصلاة يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا والإسلام والمسلمين، وبارك فيهم في هذه البلاد وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وجميع موتى المسلمين، وارحمنا إذا ما صرنا إليهم يا رب العالمين، واجمعنا بهم عندك في جنة الفردوس، واجعلنا جميعا من أهل حضرتك أهل النظر والشهود إلى وجهك الكريم يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين. آمين يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، believers، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. صبحكم الله بالخير، طبتم وطاب مشاكم، وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah, accept our good deeds, and forgive our sins, our shortcoming. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Today inshallah the first class of Sirat al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're gonna summarize all the seerah in like four classes. Get the major points, main points in his seerah alayhi salatu wasalam. Four classes, inshallah gonna finish all of it inshallah. When we talk about Prophet Muhammad, and we must as a believer know Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, his life, his family life, scientific life, social life, everything about him, we should learn, as he is the leader, the prophet, our shafi'a, supporter in akhirah before Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with. If we reflect and think about this dunya, you will discover and find the best thing in this dunya, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to know Him, the best thing. Who is our dalil, our operator, guide to know Allah? Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we should know Him. And when we know Him, we love Him. When we love Him, we follow His steps sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's start with basics information about him. His name, Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Abd al-Muttalib. Shabab bitu'na bitu' al-madrasa, school, they memorize, mashallah, here in the school, half of the seerah. Teach them, tell them migration, and they memorize it, mashallah. So among them, memorize the name of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi sallam. We have here Salif, where Muhammad, Kabil, Adam, where are you? Sleeping? Muhammad ibn Abdullah, ibn Abd al-Muttalib, ibn Hashim, ibn Abd Manaf, ibn Qusay, ibn Kilab, ibn Murrah, ibn Ka'b, ibn Lu'ay, ibn Ghalib, ibn Fihr, ibn Malik, ibn Nadr, ibn Kinana, ابن خزيمة، ابن مدركة، ابن إلياس، ابن مضر، ابن نزار، ابن معد، ابن عدنان، ابن أدد، ابن مقوم، ابن ناحور، ابن تيحر، ابن يعرب،
ابن يشجب ابن ناب ابن إسماعيل ابن إبراهيم from الرسول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم till سيدنا إبراهيم 30 names and then after إبراهيم ابن آزر واسمه تارح ابن ناحور ابن ساحور ابن راعو ابن فالخ ابن عيبر ابن شالخ ابن أرفخشذ ابن سام ابن نوح from رسول محمد till سيدنا نوح 40 names and then after نوح ابن لامي ابن متوشلخ ابن خنوخ ابن يرد ابن مهيلل ابن قين ابن يانش ابن شيث ابن آدم so النسب الشريف his lineage from him till عدنان is authentic عدنان علماء Syrians and علماء السيرة scholars of Syrah they agreed on that from عدنان and up they have different opinions this is one of the authentic lineage about him عليه السلام so from him till Adam 50 names نعم صلى الله عليه وسلم His mother, Amina bint Wahb. Amina bint Wahb. Subhanallah. Father, Abdullah, servant of Allah. Mother, Amina. Amina from Amn. Amn, safety. Security. Safe. The meaning of the name. Bint Wahb ibn Abdi Manaf. Abdi Manaf, this is different from Abdi Manaf, grandfather of his father. Okay, to Abdi Manaf. But all of them from Quraysh. From a Quraysh. But this lineage get out from Mecca, from Quraysh, and settled in Yathrib, in Medina. His mother, Amina, from Quraysh. But they settled in Yathrib, in Medina. So her nasab, Amina bint Wahb, ibn Abdi Manaf, ibn Zuhra. ابن كلاب ابن مرة ابن كعب ابن لؤي كلاب ابن كلاب here they come together in one grandfather ابن كلاب so كلاب get زهرة and قصي قصي grandfather of Prophet Muhammad and زهرة grandfather of آمنة mother of Prophet Muhammad ابن كلاب ابن مرة ابن كعب ابن لؤي ابن غالب ابن فهر ابن مالك ابن النضر ابن كنانة ابن خزيمة ابن مدركة ابن إلياس ابن مضر ابن نزار ابن معد ابن عدنان لنينش تل آدم عليه السلام طيب when he was born عليه الصلاة والسلام he was born in the place Mecca the time 571. Bimrad that number. It's very easy. 571. 571 after Jesus. After Al-Masih alayhi salam. 571. In Mecca. Passed away. 632. 632. 632. In Medina. His age, 63. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I want to go for his mother, Amina. Amina bint Wahb. She raised in a great family, Qurashiyya, from Quraysh. She belonged to Quraysh. She was a lonely girl. For her father and mother. No brother, no sister. But the Quran speaks about وَبَنَاتِ خَالِكَ وَبَنَاتِ خَالَاتِكَ This is concerning the family that belong to Amina. But Prophet Muhammad doesn't have خال. خال, the uncle from the side of mother. Instead of a mother, we call it khal or khala for female. Am or amma from the side of father. Am, uncle, or amma, aunt. So she doesn't have brothers nor sisters. She was alone. طيب, what happened? Abd al-Muttalib, when his son Abdullah grew and reached now like 24, something like that. He went to Wahb, father of Amina, and asked for marriage. Father and the daughter agreed, and they established the ceremony and the marriage processing. And there happened marriage, and she get pregnant. Abdullah, his job, father of Prophet Muhammad, trader, businessman. So among his work to travel here and there, and Arab in general at that time, they have two major journeys. One to Syria, one to Al-Yemen. رحلة الشتاء والصيف. صيف, summer, they go to Syria. الشتاء, winter, they go to Yemen. Make trading, business, and so on. So he went to Gaza. Gaza, in Palestine. Sham, we speak Sham. All this area right now, Jordan, Palestine, Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, all that called a Sham. Well, Arab in the history say Sham means all these borders, all these countries. Right now, 3-4 countries, but used to be one. So he went to Gaza for trading. And while he come back in his journey, he gets sick. He went with caravan, not alone. So he asked him to stay in with his part family in Yathrib. In Yathrib. And the rest of the caravan went back to Mecca. In Yathrib, they stayed like 1 month for remedy, healing, shifa, ilaj. But after a month, he passed away. He passed away. Amina in Mecca, pregnant like 3-4 months. So Prophet Muhammad doesn't see his father. Father passed away while he was in the belly of his mother, alayhi salatu wassalam. She have been very sad and sorrow. And she think about that baby is coming and father passed away. She look about support, help, and so on. But look here, the family of Prophet Muhammad is a great family. Bani Hashim, Quraysh, they are leader. They are leader of Mecca. And whoever leader of Mecca, leader for all Arabia. Because al-Haram make Mecca leader for all Arabia. So leader of Mecca, leader for Arabia. And she used to take the baby after she delivered Prophet Muhammad, take him to visit his father, grave, in Yathrib. At that time called Yathrib. Time. Let's go to the minutes when she delivered the Prophet Muhammad. Who attended that? Like three women. One of them, professional, midwife, is called Qabila, al-Shifa. Al-Shifa, mother of Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. She was the Qabila. Qabila means midwife. And Fatima, al-Sahabi, mother of Uthman ibn Abi al-As. Ayman. Ayman, she was the servant inside the family. And she was mother of Usama ibn Zayd. And Thuwaybah. Thuwaybah, Jariyah, servants or slave girl for Abi Lahab. SubhanAllah. When Prophet Muhammad came, let's go to the mother and she talking about her pregnancy. She was different, not like any other. Very light. She doesn't feel, you know, pain like others. And she used to see dreams during their pregnancy. The dreams took her about that is unique. Child, baby. You carry in your belly unique child. And she saw many dreams. Among them, she saw a light come out of her, and this light cover from Mecca till Syria, Sham. Something like that, different. Among them, she hears something. Somebody talk to her, you are blessed by this baby, and name him Muhammad. That name wasn't known at that time, name Muhammad. Name Muhammad, it wasn't known among the Arab and the culture in that time. What Muhammad mean? Muhammad, wa Ahmad, wa Mahmud, wa Hamid, all that root come from Hamd. Hamd means praise. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that the description come in the Bible, previous books, about his description from Al-Hamd. Jesus alayhi salam, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِ مِنْ بَعْدِ إِسْمُهُ أَحْمَدٍ. It's clear. So she delivered the baby. It was very easy, very simple. And she, subhanAllah, has mawhiba. She has, you know, talent. She was talent in poetry. In poetry. She used to go every year to visit the grave of the father, Abdullah, and visit her family over there, and let Muhammad go to his father's grave every year. And after 5 years or 6 years, one day when she in visit and she came back, she felt sick in the way, and she felt she gonna die. She was at that time like, she married like 20 and passed away like 25, 26. She asked Muhammad, baby now like 5, 6 years, and advised him by amazing shi'r, poetry, amazing poetry. All of it, subhanAllah, indicates to Tawheed, to Islam. However, still, there is no risala, there is no message, revelation. Nah. But that means she has knowledge about Tawheed, and there were many people in Mecca like that. So she said that, I'm going to translate it. بَارَكَ فِيكَ اللَّهُ مِنْ غُلَامٍ يَبْنَ الَّذِي فِي حَوْمَةِ الْحَمَامِ نجا بعون الملك العلام فودا غداة الضرب بالسهام. May Allah bless you, O my boy, the son of the one saved in difficult time by Allah's powers. Because his father, Abdullah, subhanAllah, his long story, but summarize it, grandfather Abdul Muttalib, after he, Allah blessed him by 11 boys, he said they're gonna sacrifice like Ibrahim. The next one was Abdullah, subhanAllah. So the people told him, I'm gonna sacrifice your son, what happened? No, don't do that. So they make draw lots, lay a qura, between him and camels, number 10, 20, 50, till 100 camels, And then the Qur'a, the draw lots come to the camels, they sacrifice 100 camels. This is the way. So she speak here about this story. How Allah survived the father from that incident. So when they draw lots to save him from sacrifice by 100 camels. بِمِئَةٍ مِنْ إِبِلٍ سَوَامٍ مِنْ صَحَّ مَا أَبْصَرْتُ فِي الْمَنَامِ Look. فَأَنْتَ مَبْعُوثٌ إِلَى الْأَنَامِ تُبْعَثُ فِي الْحِلِّ وَفِي الْحَرَمِ If what I saw correct, so in her dream, if what I saw correct, so you are an envoy to the people. You are envoy inside and outside sacred Mecca, for Mecca and people around Mecca. تبعث بالتوحيد والإسلام دين أبيك البر إبراهيم إبراهيمي. You are envoy with Tawheed and Islam, the religion of your father Ibrahim. فالله ينهاك عن الأصنام ألا تواليها مع الأقوام. Allah forbids you from idols, not to associate them with people. This diwan, قصيدة, by Amina bint Wahb, mother of Prophet Muhammad, is clear. She invites her son and advises him by Iman and Islam and Tawheed. There is another qasida, but it's not the time for mention it now. She passed away in the way between Medina and Mecca, and she buried Umm Ayman and some Bedouins from the desert to help her to bury Amina in a hill called Al-Abwa. Called Al-Abwa. It's available right now. Some people go to visit that place between Mecca and Medina. Rasulullah, before he passed away, few days, he went and visited her and cried so much. And all people around him, the Sahaba, cried so much for this incident, the situation. Father, the son, Muhammad, stand before the grave of his mother, which passed away. He remember when he was 5-6 years old, and she advised him by these amazing words. Inshallah, next week, we're going to talk more about Al-Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam seerah, prophet biography, to learn and to have these solid information about our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Wallahu a'la wa a'lam wa salli allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen jazakumullahu khayra wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.